time. So it is August, we're approaching Q4, and you know, the big block holidays are Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas, and already now I'm seeing Halloween shirt sales every day. And then come September, even more, and then October, it's pretty much nothing but Halloween stuff selling. So if you can kind of enter the market now or in September, you're kind of setting yourself up to get some easy sales, which is a great thing generally with merch, because if you can get easy sales, for one, you get more sales in your account, which allows you to tier up. For two, you might get reviews on the shirts, and then that data, the sales data, is stored for next year. That means they can become year-round sellers, and their reviews, of course, are great because they add that social proof, things like that. So hopefully it's clear why it's important to enter these holidays with some preparation, some designs ready to go. So what this video will be about is just having gone through Halloween last year and seen some of the pretty crazy trends, I thought I would just give a brief overview of what I saw selling last year and what will probably sell again this year, because history tends to rhyme, right? Or if history doesn't repeat itself, it rhymes. It's a great quote by Mark Twain. So first things first, we'll probably be seeing a lot of Trump-related shirts. You can intersect Trump with holidays. Of course, just make sure that you're steering clear of trademarks, because along with these big holidays comes a lot of like trademarks surrounding it. You know, Thanksgiving has trademarks like thankful around it, which are pretty dumb, but they're there. And then Halloween will have trademarks on a lot of things. Hocus Pocus, Just Here for the Booze, Battle Switch on the Block, so on and so forth. So always make sure that you're running that check before you're entering the market. Here, Trumpkin shirts are already starting to sell. So that was a big seller last year and will be a big seller this year. I teach the Cutest Pumpkins in the Patch. I had a shirt that said that exact thing last year. And at one point, if you wrote cute teacher shirt in the search, mine was the number one ranking, as it was selling like crazy, 20, 30 shirts a day. So I guess not that crazy, because I've had shirts that sold more than that. So then another big niche, I don't recall it last year, but in general it's a strong niche to get into, is like the gaming niche. So if you can intersect gaming with whatever holiday you're doing, it's great. The trend Pause My Game to Be Here, which was big last year and I've had some great sellers, has come back this year, and you'll see a lot of those shirts selling. And so I think you'll see some nice intersects going on with anything that you can think of, whether it's like math teachers, whether it's like sport coaches. You can always create the pumpkin into like soccer ball. You can always intersect them to make designs for every kind of segment of the market that you can think of. But some of the bigger sellers, right, are the things like matching shirts, right? For example, I'm with the witch, and there's like, again, check the trademark, but then there's an arrow pointing left. Or like this pumpkin, half of a pumpkin face and then another half pumpkin face. And if you look at the data, actually, funny shirts for couples is one of the most searched keywords out there. And it's kind of, in my belief, an underserved market, right? So that was a huge seller last year. Another huge seller was Just Here for the Booze. Absolutely crazy. I think there was just a few people I know selling hundreds of shirts a day just with that phrase. But again, I believe it's trademarked, so just be careful about that. This one was big. It just said, "I'm a mouse, duh." And then now there are spin-offs. But I believe that phrase is from a movie, so just keep that in mind. The dabbing, massive. You have dabbing skeletons playing soccer. You have dabbing pumpkins. Dabbing was an absolute crazy trend last year, and I'm sure it'll stay strong this year. One of my best-selling shirts last year was a dabbing shirt. I think at one point I sold over a couple hundred a day just from one design. And this one right here, these costume shirts, big sellers. Big, big, big sellers. And they apply also for Christmas if you just have like that reindeer, just like a brown thing on a brown shirt. Or like you can do it for a bear or like a cow. Very kind of easy to do, and they fall under the category of like easy, fast, last minute Halloween costumes. And you can also see this one up here, which you just kind of like cut off the head of an animal, and then voila, you have a costume. So those are some pretty big, those were very big trends last year. There was a big trend last year, which was for the Thanksgiving one, you had like a pumpkin pie that looked like Pac-Man chasing whipped cream. Again, that's a bit of a copyright infringement risk, so I wouldn't do that. Another big one, always, always big, are the pregnancy shirts. Of course, never write the word maternity in the listing because that immediately triggers a rejection. But pregnancy shirts linked with all the holidays, whether it's feeling stuffed at the Thanksgiving, but you have the footprints, and it's like the course, always. But I think I have one which is selling right now. It's called The Guy Behind the Pumpkin or something like that. Selling very well. So that was just a quick overview. Of course, there's countless more things that'll sell. Just basic shirts will say boo. There's the biggest ever. I think it was like rivaling number one along with those bloody M&M shirts. This right here. Look how basic that is. It's basically just the kind of the cute design with spiders, a witch hat, and then like some nice font. It was just nuts last year. I don't know if you can see the keeper thing here. Let me just see if I can figure that. Sometimes you can see it, sometimes you can't. It was just selling like bananas. Bananas last year. Where'd it go to? Woo! Look at that. Bonkers. 1, 4, 4, 5. Right? Now we were just... I'm just curious. You know, I'm just curious what that would translate to. 1, 4, 4, 5. Oh, good. Very good. So it was a great seller. So that's the potential of Halloween, and you'll see it with a lot of these. Oh, emoji shirts were huge. Be careful of the term emoji. I don't get it why these guys are still up. I believe that's a trademark term. The correct term to use is emoticon, or I guess the safe term to use, but emoji. People search for emoji, so it ranks well. It's already at 80K. Oh, God. Look at this bad boy. Woo! Pretty similar to the other one we just saw. Pretty amazing stuff. Wow, it stayed low for a while. And now it's beginning to dive. It's already hit 50K, so another thing, if you just look up that pumpkin emoji t-shirt. Last point here. Alright, so it features it'll be hard to stand out, but it features 286 results. So you're like, oh, it's not that bad considering how much traffic it's getting. Right? That's what you might think. But then I would urge you to do this, sort by newest arrivals to get a more accurate picture of what there is, 650 results. It's the same thing with, for example, let's search pumpkin. Okay, results, you're like, not bad. And now if you sort by newest arrivals, over 1,000. Because Amazon has started to just feature the sellers, right? And of course it does, it rotates shirts here and there. But to get a better sense of like how big the competition is, go to newest arrivals. It's much more accurate. All right, I think that's good for now. Just give you a good taste of some of the trends from last year that are gonna just happen again. I can already see it. It's quite predictable sometimes with trends. All right, this was your first time. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully that is useful and gives you some kind of ideas and motivation to get started for Halloween because it's big. Trends. Oh, last thing that sold super well last year, it was a Peter shirt. So it said one said Peter, and then the matching shirt said Pumpkin Eater. Those sold like crazy. We all sold a lot of those. All right. So if this was useful, feel free to like, comment, ask me any questions, subscribe, check out other videos. Thank you very much for watching, my friend. And